Want to see how to add some sparkle to the things you print on your Bambu Lab 3D printer? Well, today on the BV3D channel, we'll check out a new product that lets you do exactly that with four different patterns. I'm Brian, and you are watching BV3D. Hello, 3D printing friends, and welcome back. Bambu Lab just introduced a new product for their printers, and they sent it here to the BV3D channel so I could show it to you. It's on their online store as the Bambu 3D Effect Sheet Combo with Plate. It kind of rolls right off the tongue, doesn't it? It's a spring steel sheet and four effect sheets that you can apply to it. The effect sheets are sticker-style print surfaces that have diffraction grating patterns on them, and those patterns get transferred to the first layer of your 3D prints. The four effects are Galaxy, Starry, Carbon Fiber, and Diamond. It's available for the Bambu Lab A1, the X1 series, and P1 series printers for $27 US, and also for the A1 Mini for only $17 US. When you get this, it comes as the spring steel sheet and the four sticker sheets. You have to install them yourself. It's not difficult to do, but you have to be careful to get the sticker sheets aligned properly and avoid getting bubbles under them as you're sticking them down. Bambu Lab has an alignment jig you can download and print. Start with a clean flex plate. I cleaned mine with a few wipes of isopropyl alcohol. Then use the alignment jig to clamp the sticker sheet to the spring steel sheet. That keeps them both perfectly lined up. Then peel the backing partway off the sticker sheet and start pressing it down. Work from the center of the front edge, pressing toward the left and right sides. Once the front is stuck down, you can start using a left and right motion. Once you've got the sticker started, you can remove the jig. Keep peeling the backing off and pressing the sticker down, using that back and forth motion until you reach the back of the flex plate. Finally, remove the protective film from the surface of the sheet. Now you can remove the existing flex plate from your printer and use the effect sheet. When it comes to printing on the effect sheets, you'll need to make a few adjustments to your settings. First, Bambu Lab recommends setting the bed temperature between 60 and 65 degrees Celsius for PLA and between 35 and 45 degrees Celsius for TPU. You can change that here in the settings for your chosen filament. Also, for the X1 series printers, disable the micro LiDAR features. The scattered reflections from the effect sheets confuses the sensors. The two features making use of the micro LiDAR are the flow calibration at the beginning of a print and the first layer inspection. And Bambu Lab says to disable the build plate placement feature as well. You can turn off first layer inspection and build plate placement detection on the device tab in Bambu Studio by clicking the print options button. And you can turn off the flow calibration when you send a job to the printer. Just uncheck the box before you send it. Hey, if you're getting value from this video, I would really appreciate a subscribe. That lets me know I'm making content you enjoy and you want to see more like it. Thanks. So here's an example. This is a phone case I downloaded from printables.com. It's called iPhone 11 Pro Max Case Slim, and it's from designer Eonfly. If you're rocking an old iPhone like I am and you want to print one of your own, there's a link in the description. I printed this in some blue Bambu Lab Basic PLA. And look at that, when the light hits it just right, it's got an awesome rainbow star pattern on it. Now this would also look cool in like a dark gray or black with a carbon fiber pattern on it. Anyway, I think it's pretty cool and that's why I wanted to share it with you. Now, it's not all unicorns and rainbows. Okay, well, there are a lot of rainbows. What I'm getting at is there are some things to be aware of. You've probably noticed that these are called effect sheets and not high-performance bed adhesion sheets. That's because models may not stick as well to these sheets, and that's why Bambu Lab suggests increasing the bed temperature to help your models stick better. But don't use glue sticks or other bed adhesion helpers. They'll fill in the microscopic grooves on the sheets that make the patterns, and then the effect won't transfer to your first layer. As far as filament choices go, Bambu Lab recommends using the effect sheets only with PLA and TPU. Also, be aware the effect sheets are considered a consumable. They will wear out with use. How long will they last? I don't know. I just got them and I've only printed the phone case on them. To keep the sheets working as long as possible, keep them clean. Hot water and dish soap can help with that. It's also a good idea to place your models in different locations on the bed when you slice and print to kind of even out the wear. And finally, the effect sheets are meant to be stuck on the flex plate only once. If you've got the starry sheet installed and you remove it to install the carbon fiber one, you won't be using that starry sheet again. My advice to you is to pick the sheet you think you'll enjoy the most and use that until it doesn't work well anymore or until you get tired of it. Then swap it for another sheet. So that's the Bambu Lab Effects Sheets Kit. It's not a productivity booster, it doesn't make your printer faster, but it is a fun, easy way to add some extra flair to the things you print. Make a phone case, print a gift box, have some fun with it. What kind of things would you print on it? Comment now and let me know. Now, currently, Bambu Lab isn't selling the effects sheets without the spring steel sheet, but hopefully that's something they're thinking about doing. For instance, if the carbon fiber effect sheet is your favorite, it would be cool if you could just buy that one pattern without having to buy the whole kit. Anyway, there's a link to this in the description if you want to check it out. Thanks again to Bambu Lab for sending this over free of charge so I could show it to you. Thank you for watching, and big thanks to everyone who supports the channel, whether with channel memberships or by using the links in the description. If you liked this episode, give it a thumbs up and maybe subscribe so you don't miss new ones. Well, 3D printing friends, that's about all the time we have for this one. And now that we're at the end, let's go print something cool and starry, or carbon fibery, or diamondy, or galaxy.